This is a microbit. It's a microcontroller, or you can call it a pocket computer. You can make some easy and fun programs with microbit. For example, when I press the button A, all the 25 LEDs light up. And these are like candles. And this program is basically that you have to blow the candles, just like you blow the candles on a birthday cake. So let's test it out. Let's try it one more time. Let's learn how to write this program. So I'm here on a website called makecode.microbit.org. There are several ways in which you can code your microbit, but if you are familiar with Scratch and you know block-based drag-and-drop programming, then I suggest that you make a start with makecode.microbit.org. So here I'm saying start a new project. You can give any name to your project. I'm saying candles. So this is the user interface for MakeCode, and like I said, these are, you know, block-based programs that if you have seen Scratch, then you will be familiar with some of these programming blocks. But you also have the option to code in JavaScript and Python. But I'm going to stick with block-based programming. So what we want to do is, basically we want to switch on all the 25 LEDs by default, and then when we blow on the microbit, then the candle should gradually switch off. So by default, you've got two sets of commands here. One is called onStart and one is called forever or a forever loop. So what we are saying is that onStart, we go to basic, and here you've got options like show a number, show some LEDs, show some icon, show a string, etc., which we will look at. But right now I'm just saying, I'm going to pick up this block called show LEDs, and then I'm saying that on start make all the LEDs switch on. And then once on start we've got all these LEDs on, then you can test your code, because when I run this simulator, it's showing me that all my LEDs are on, because that's the command we have given. Now what we want to say is, when we are blowing on the microbit, actually we are just producing a sound. And we are going to use the sound sensor or the microphone, which is on board the microbit version 2. We are going to just say that if sound level is over a certain level, then the LEDs should switch off. So for this, I'm going to go into logic and I'm going to drag out a if then conditional statement, and I'm going to put it inside the forever loop. And then if you go to input and you scroll down, for microbit version 2, you have these additional blocks. And here I'm going to bring out this sound level programming block. This is like a variable which stores whatever is the level of sound which is coming through the microphone on the microbit. And then I'm going to go back into logic and I'm going to get a comparison statement, and I'm going to bring out this statement. And I'm saying that if the sound level is more than some value, then we want something to happen to the LEDs, and essentially we want the LEDs to be off. And the way to do that is, you go to LED and you bring out the unplot command. So just to show you how this plot and unplot command works, I'm going to create another input and I'm going to say when button A is pressed, I'm going to go back to LEDs and I'm going to get a plot command, and I'm going to disable this command for now. So when I run the simulator, nothing is happening. And what we are saying is that when button A is pressed, you switch on the LED which is at X0, Y0. So if I press A, this LED comes on. So if you see the grid here, we've got a 5x5 grid, and this top left corner is 0, 0. And then X increases here, so it'll become 1x, 2x, 3x, 4x, like that. So 0x to 4x, and y increases here. So this is 0y, this will be 1y, 2y, 3y, 4y, like that. So if I say, for example, if I want the third LED to light up from the top, then that will be x2 and y0. So if I just go here and I say x2, y0, and I run the simulator, press A, then my third LED is switched on. So if I say y4, which means is the bottommost row, and when I press button A, indeed my x2, y4 LED is lit up. And likewise, if something is on, then I can put a little pause command. So I'm saying just pause for 1 second, and then I'm saying unplot x2, y4. So you can use this slider, or you can simply input the command here, input the number here. So now when I press button A, this LED lights up for 1 second, and then it switches off. It lights up, it switches off. So that is how we can light up an LED by using the plot command, or switch a LED off by using the unplot command. And that is what we are going to use for our program here. We are going to use the unplot. So we are saying here, on start, have all the LEDs on, and then when the sound level is over a certain value, let's say the value we put here is 100, we are saying unplot x2 y4 here, and that is why this LED is not glowing. But what we want is all of the LEDs, when we blow, all of the LEDs should get switched off. So for that, I'm going to go into math, and I'm going to bring out pick a random number command. I'm going to put it here, and like I said, value of x can go from 0 to 4, and I'm going to duplicate this, and I'm saying the same thing for y. So what we are saying is, if you can see it in the simulator, actually what I'll do is, instead of on start, I'm going to put this inside button A. On button A press, I'm going to get rid of this. So what we are saying is, when we press button A, all the LEDs should light up, and when the sound level is more than 100, then they should switch off. So here so this is on the simulator, this is how you control the level of sound. So I'm going to reduce it. So when I press button A, all my 25 LEDs are lit up, and as I increase the sound level, you will see that when the sound level goes over 100, the LEDs gradually switch off. So this blowing candles program is this simple. I hope you will try it. We can transfer this to our microbit, and there are two ways of transferring. One is that you download the file to your computer and then transfer it like you transfer files to any Android phone, or if you're using Chrome browser, then on Chrome browser you can pair your microbit. So I have paired my microbit. So if I click these three dots, it's saying that it's already connected. So it's asking me, do I want to disconnect? So I don't want to disconnect. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to say download. So the program is now transferred to my microbit. When I go and I press A, and now when I will blow on the microphone, the LED should switch off. Let's try it one more time. I press button A. In this program, we have used the microphone or the sound sensor in microbit version 2. I hope you like this program and you will try it on your own.